Hey guys, Woods Farm here, just back out working on the Kubel wagon. So I'm all over the place at this point. There's all kinds of little odd things that need to get done. Stuff I've been procrastinating on, or just little detail things that I've kind of brushed past that I need to now go back and deal with. So I'm just gonna start plugging away at all these little things down here. I don't know if you can see that. There is a plate that is welded to the upper support here, and this is a reinforcement for where the window hinge bolts to. So I need to make one of those on the other side. There's a hinge on both sides, allows the window to fold forward. Another thing I need to start thinking about, I'm going to work on maybe today, is patterning and cutting out. There's a triangular kind of reinforcement to the fender right in here. It's got holes in it, and it just kind of, I think it's just to support the edge of the fender. I'm not sure if there's one at the back. I'll have to check. But what I do know is that this back part of the rear fender, right in here, there's a triangular reinforcement on the later models. Earlier model Kubels, the fender was cut flush, and then they extended it down, and they added a triangular reinforcement here. So a few inches needs to get cut off each of these fenders. I'll have to look at some pictures and kind of make a judgment call of exactly how high up I'm going to cut them. And then these reinforcements need to get fabricated out of, probably 18 gauge and put in place. I have the piano hinges, they came in, so the next step, I gotta finish this vent and think about actually securing these hatches in place, the engine lid and the trunk lid. I've got some sanding to do. I gotta go around in some places and put some more of that steel reinforced Bondo and do some sanding. So lots of work to do. It's all this little stuff. This is the kind of stuff that slows you down though, right? These little things you need to go back and do. Okay, so that's what I'm going for. Just a little triangular piece. And it has a curve there to match the fender. So I'm gonna go ahead and start by, I trace that curve there. I'm gonna cut that, and then I'm gonna make a pattern out of cardboard, and we'll try to get the proportions right. And once that's done, I'll have a better idea where to cut the fender. Okay, that's the pattern. Just give you an idea what it looks like. So now I know exactly where I wanna trim the bottom of the fender. And obviously the measurements of the Kubel aren't precisely matching the original, so at this point when it comes to details like this, it's more about just eyeballing it, getting the right look. Okay, so that's the pattern for the front triangular brace. You can see where I held it up to the fender, and this is the edge of the fender, and you can see there's the curve. Again, proportionately, this isn't going to match up, partially because the distance from the edge of the body, the rocker panel, out to the edge of the fender, it's a lot smaller on mine. I talked about that in previous videos because of the chassis different for the thing. And also my bodywork, the angle of where it cuts in is different. Kind of starts cutting in right here, whereas on an actual Kubel, it's much further back. So this becomes, the triangle on an actual Kubel is more of an actual triangle. I kind of have this weird arc here, and it's much smaller. So it looks like they have four holes across, kind of one, two, three, four, and then three, and then two, and one. I'm probably going to have to play around with that. I almost considered not even putting this piece in, but it's fairly noticeable in the Kubel wagon, and also it does actually, I think it does give some support to the fender. So I'm gonna kind of come up with my own sort of middle ground, so hopefully it kind of doesn't look weird without it, and it has some support for the fender. That's what I've come up for the reinforcing triangles. You see, there's not exactly symmetrical. This one needs to get shaved down just a tad too. It's a little bit bigger than this one, but that's, you get the idea. Okay, there's the patterns all laid out. Just got to cut 3/4 of an inch tabs that'll get bent over, and these will be used as welding points or securement points. I think on the front fenders, they are removable, so this tab here will be, it'll have like 3 or 2 bolts that'll bolt through, and it'll allow you to remove the fender. The rest of it will be welded on. And then there's going to be, along this edge, there'll be a piece of angle iron to give it support. I'm not sure if I'm going to be able to bend these to the level of accuracy that I need. So this is just the first attempt. The ones for the rear fenders, I think, I got a better idea of how they're going to work. So I think these aren't going to be an issue. The front ones, we'll see. Okay, so I've got all the brackets finished, so I'm just going to start installing them. Okay, there it is, basically in place. I think I'm going to make those holes a little bit bigger. It'll just pop out a little bit more, and it probably needs to get welded right to the rocker panel here. It's bolted to the fender and quarter panel, but that doesn't give it quite as much strength as I think welding it in here would. So probably gonna do that. That's what you end up with for the rear fender brace. Just switched it up and got this front passenger seat mounted. Driver's seat's all set up and ready to go. I just gotta flip it around. I've got 4 wig nuts to go onto that. Gonna need someone to hold the bolt from the bottom though, so that's gonna have to wait. Okay, that's the final product. Got the fenders trimmed down and I got the support there. Driver's side. Pretty happy with how these turned out. So I got a system to make these louvers. They're getting better as I go along, but essentially you got to cut it and clamp it down on a, I got an piece that's raised up here, and then I got a kind of a piece of steel, and I can actually bend it in, and then I got to tap it down from the other side just to get it flat and even, if that makes sense. Okay, there's the back grill done, or vent. It actually turned out better than I thought it was gonna. In hindsight, if I was to do another one, I wouldn't drill holes. What I did was I drilled a hole on each end and used the jigsaw to cut a line. And the jigsaw is like a quarter of an inch thick or so, so you need a fairly big hole. If I was going to do it again, I wouldn't drill the holes. I would use an angle grinder with a very thin cutting blade, and I would plunge cut. And then I would take the jigsaw and I would cut to the towards the end, and I would swoop in and make a curve. I think that would have made for a better finish. But once I got the technique for bending them, they're fairly uniform in the way they're bent in. So I'm pretty happy with that. It's just some of them aren't perfectly straight. And like I said, the circle at the top, the way that worked, not the best. But for now, it's going to do. Okay, so there's the back end all finished with the vent. Still need to weld the hinge on for the hatch for the engine compartment. Tow hooks need to get welded on. I actually went to a local shop today and they're going to plasma cut me the tow hooks for the front and back. Hopefully that doesn't cost too much. So, did a bunch of sanding. So what I'm going to do is I think I'm going to try these. What I did here is this is folded over. So the top plate, and now it's folded down, and there's plug welds, but there's a little edge here. I'm wondering, I'm going to experiment. I'm going to hit this with some body fill and just see if I can kind of blend it in so it doesn't look so noticeable. And if the result of that is good, I might use that technique in some other places. This crack here, same thing, I'm going to put body fill in there. Okay, so that's the metal reinforced filler. I'm probably going to have to put another coat here and maybe along the edge, but we're just going to see how this looks when it gets all sanded off. Okay, so I just sanded it down, and I'm going to have to give it another coat. I don't know what happened here. I actually forgot to put some along the edge here. But you can see I worked really, really carefully on this side here, and what happens is this is bent over, and it gives a nice round finish there, but then where the metal overlaps, there's a kind of a sharp edge. You can see that up here. It's not finished. But when you come down here, that bit of fill, kind of, you can feel the lump, but it's not sharp. So I'm going to go ahead and do this for the rest of the vehicle. All these edges. I'm also going to go ahead and do what I've done here. I'm just going to cover these welds. And then when you sand it down, most of that body fill disappears, but and you can kind of see the top of the weld. But what I'm hoping, it just makes it kind of gets rid of that pit. There's kind of an edge around it. So for the bit of effort that it takes to do this, I think it'll probably look better when it once it's painted. It's the first time doing something like this, so I don't know. You know, who knows, next year I might be repainting the whole thing. I might have to strip it down and, you know, put more fill on it and repaint it. I don't know. We'll see. Anyways, I'm going to wrap this video up here. As always, if you have any questions or comments, leave them below. And thanks for watching.